Did we scare you? Scared the hell out of him. We're going tropical today, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Cockatales. That's cocktails with a cockatoo. I'm the Wizard. This is Oz. We're here for your enjoyment and entertainment and education. So today we're going down to the Caribbean. I have spent a lot of time, years and years and years, working on cruise ships, probably 25 in all. And we have drunk a lot of Mai Tais. I will tell you, most of them are very mediocre. This Mai Tai, on the other hand, is the one Mai Tai that all my families and friends say that for those people that don't like rum drinks, they love this cocktail. Now, this is also going to be the most complicated cocktail that we're probably going to ever make because it has 7 different ingredients. What? 7? Yeah, that's why no one at the bar is ever going to make the cocktail this way because it's just way too much trouble. Would you come up here for a minute? Why, thank you. That's perfect. Hang on. Here we go. Woo! Ooh, almost fooled them, but not quite. So, it's a Mai Tai. We're going to have, of course, some Mai Tai tiki bitters. Tiki bitters, yes. 2 of these. 1, 2. Just a little bit of lime juice, like an ounce. And please, use fresh lime juice. Do not use the stuff that comes out of that plastic lime or other fake lime juice. It takes you 30 seconds to squeeze the lime juice. It is well worth it. Next up, some Nassau Royale. This is cool. This is a vanilla-flavored liqueur from Nassau, Bahamas. Distributed by Bacardi. Really good. Not getting any money or promos for it. I wish you would. Maybe send some. But this is a really good vanilla way to add vanilla to a cocktail. And so we're going to do a 1/2 ounce of this. Ooh, I'm going to get right there at the 1/2 ounce line. Perfect. We're going to add 1/4 ounce of turbinado syrup. And like always, the recipe is down in the comments. We hope you'll look at those. Give us some feedback. Tell us what you like, what you don't like. Most importantly, please subscribe. So the turbinado syrup. Syrups are really, this is going to be just 1/4 ounce. Just a little bit to add a little sweetness to us, but not too much. We've got to be careful. That's why it's only 1/4 ounce. And to make the syrup, it's really simple. All you got to do is 1 part turbinado sugar, 1 part water. Boil it all together for a minute so you can mix it up, and there you go. Pretty straightforward. Orangite. Ah, this is so good, my friend. Where are you from? I think this is from France. Yes. I would spit upon you to make you understand. This is an almond flavor syrup. You might be able to substitute something like amaretto for this, but I highly encourage getting proper orangite because this is a key ingredient in flavor. And we're going to put 1 full ounce in here. All right, after the orangite, we're going for, we need some orange liqueur. It could be Grand Marnier, it could be Curacao, it could be a one-off like what we're using here today. And we only need 1/3 of that, but I want a little bit of orange liqueur in there. No, that's not quite 1/3. Here we go. I try to be really precise in these things. And then, of course, we need some dark rum. Now, not the fanciest or best dark rum. You can replace this with any good blackstrap rum. But you know what? Meyers isn't bad for this. And I'm not a huge Meyers fan, but I will take 1 ounce of Meyers and throw this in there. And then, of course, we have to have some amber rum because it's a Mai Tai. You never can have enough rum in a Mai Tai. And as you see, like our bourbon, we buy these in these small bottles. And I'm using Appleton Estate. This is my favorite rum for mixing cocktails. I find it very smooth. It's very reasonably priced. And I have this old bottle that has the handle, so I like that a lot. Now, we're going to have to give this a shake because we've got a lot of different densities in there, and that's the only way to get them mixed up as well as we would like. 15 seconds, please. Hang on, Ozzy! We shake ourselves around the oil. Coming back. Wait, look. The cockatoos have been drinking. I don't know how that happens. Something here at the tavern. Anyway, now, we take our hurricane glass. We're going to pour this in there. Oh, what a nice pour that one is. All right, this guy's good. We're going to add, of course, because it is a tiki drink, we have to have our foo-foo little umbrella, a little bit of fruit on it. I got a slice of lime, a slice of orange there. Wave the magic wand! Mai Tai! And there it is. And you will find, because of all the different ingredients, this is going to be a much more complex Mai Tai than you're ever going to get anywhere else. And yeah, it's a bit of a pain to get all these ingredients, but my God, this is really good. What do you think there, pal? Maybe we have to slide some tricks or stories in here because you're just being pretty quiet and lumpy. Sorry, but we're shooting this during his usual nap time today. You know, so Oz is 40 years old. Well, we've been together 40 years. He's at least 40 years old. And for a cockatoo of this type, that's an older bird. He likes to get up at 9 or 10 in the morning. He likes his one in the afternoon nap. He likes to be in bed by 6 o'clock. This is the lifestyle I am dreaming of. When I grow up, can I be you? You're the dad. Love you. Thank you very much. We'll see you. Please subscribe next time on Cockatails.